Hello, Gavin Hoey here with another Photoshop tutorial, and this week I'm going to show you how to make this postcard montage. I'm even going to show you how to make the background and even these little push pins as well. Now we've only got 10 minutes to fit this in, so we need to get cracking. So let's close that down and start making a new empty image. We'll go to File and New. I'm not going to use the standard preset, but make my own. I want to make my image a little bit bigger than an image that comes off my camera. So I'm going to make it 4,000 pixels wide by 3,000 pixels high. Okay, so there's our basic image. Onto that, we need to put some texture. Now, I'm going to do that on its own separate layers. As far as possible, I'm going to keep this separated out so I have a new empty layer. And I'm going to get the rectangular marquee and drag a small rectangle over the image like that. Now we're going to put a texture into that rectangle, but we can't put it on now because we have an empty layer. We've got to have some color in there. So let's click our foreground color and choose a suitable background. I'm looking for a sort of yellowy beigey color really. Round about there, that looks pretty good. And then we'll go to Edit and fill with the foreground color. Right, now let's put that texture. Filter, texture. Texturizer is the tool of choice, and I'm going to change the texture. I'm not going to use the brick one. I'm going to use this sandstone one, which I really like, and I'm going to push the scale all the way up 200% right the way to the top, like so. Now, even though we push the scale up to maximum, the texture is tiny. You can barely see it at all. So the trick here is to unselect this and then use the free transform and stretch it out. So we're taking that little texture and we're stretching it out over a much bigger area. And now you can see the texture. Now, if we'd had applied it to the whole screen in one go, it would have been really small. But by stretching it out, we're increasing the size and now we can actually see it working. But it's a bit kind of flat, it's a bit uniform. So we're going to put some shadows and highlights in here by making another new layer, another empty layer, and making another small selection in the corner and resetting our colors to the standard black and white and using the filter render clouds filter. There we go. And then get rid of the selection and stretch that out as well. So we do the same thing. Lovely, there we are. Now, same problem we have here. We can't actually see anything else. We've made it really big, but where's the texture gone? Well, it's underneath it on its own layer. So we're going to try and blend these two together using the blend modes. Now, some of them work better than others. I particularly like the soft light one. That seems to work very well indeed. Now, we just need to collapse these layers down to a single background layer. So we'll do that. Flatten image. There we go. And that's our background completed. Now, we need to put some pictures onto that, of course. So I've got one here. Here we go. Now these pictures I've kind of worked on already. We'll just get the move tool and drag and drop it on. I've made mine small enough to fit in nicely, but on yours you may find they're quite large and you need to use free transform to shrink them down to this sort of size. Now that's great, but I want to make it stand off the background by putting a drop shadow and maybe a bit of a border in there as well. So let's do that by using layers. You can see when we dragged and dropped, our image became a layer. And we can use the layer styles. That's this little FX icon down here. Let's start off by adding in a drop shadow. Now the drop shadow, fairly easy to use. You can put the angle to whatever you like. The distance puts your shadow further away from your image or closer. And the size makes it soft and fuzzy. So we'll have a nice sort of drop shadow like that. Whilst we're here, we'll put a stroke border on as well. So let's click the little stroke here. Now, this has to be one of the most bizarre things in Photoshop. And that's quite a thing. There are a lot of bizarre things in Photoshop. But by default, you get this lovely bright red border. Kind of looks really 80s. It's showing my age. Let's just change that to a white border instead. We're going to increase the size so it's a bit thicker. But when we increase the size, you find it covers up the drop shadow. So that's no good. So let's change the position to inside so you can see the drop shadow as well as the border. Okay, there we go. So that's added in our border effect. It's added it in as a little layer FX. You can see it there, and we're going to be using that to our advantage later on. Okay, so we better find some more pictures to go on here. So I've got another one here, and we're going to just drag and drop that on using the same trick, using the move tool, and just dragging and dropping like that. And we'll keep adding images in. I've got about 6 or 7 to add in total. There we go. And we'll find another one. not worrying where they're going for now, because I'll sort them out. Now, you'll notice these are all images of Venice. And we've got our little gondola here, or gondolier. He took us round the Venice area, and it was lovely. And he sang away, and he said, if you pay me a bit more money, I will stop singing. I was tempted to pay him, to be honest. Fortunately, he was better at boating than he was at singing. Okay, last one. Here we go. Nice evening sunset in Venice. Great. So, there we are. There's all the pictures together on the screen. Now we can sort these out. But at the moment, I can only move one layer around. But the trick, up here, top corner, when you have the Move tool active, top left, choose Auto Select Layer. Now, normally, I recommend people to turn that off because it can be really annoying. But for this job, we're going to turn it on. So let's just move this around and we'll put this one, where should we put that one down there maybe, that one across, and they can go almost anywhere you want to really, of course. I mean, I'm trying to just get a kind of pattern going on here so these don't all line up, because what I don't want is this sort of regular pattern like that. I want them all to be slightly disjointed from each other so none of them overlap on their edges. Okay, that looks pretty good. There we go. We'll be happy with that. Now, that's the images in place, but each one now needs its own separate border and own separate drop shadow. Now, that can be a bit of a pain because it took us a minute or two, and this is only a 10-minute video. So here's the trick. Where we did one, we have this little FX icon on its layer. Okay. Now, if we hold the Alt key or the Option key on a Mac, I can drag that FX onto another layer, and rather than it taking it off, it copies it. So I can keep adding it on to these layers, all of them like that, until every single one has its own layer style. Brilliant. There we go. So that's added in the same effect to every image. And the only thing we're left to do now is to add in the little push pins in the corner, the little drawing pins. So let's go in nice and tight here. And we'll do these on their own layer, of course. Try and keep things separated out as much as possible. We'll make a small circular selection using the elliptical marquee. I'm going to hold shift on the keyboard. That'll make sure that my selection is a perfect circle. Now, I want sort of gold push pins, so let's make this colour. Let's choose a sort of yellowy goldy colour from up here. And we'll have a darker version for the background. So let's find a sort of darker gold. Yeah, there we go. That looks pretty good. And then we're going to put a gradient just inside this circle. So we'll get the gradient tool. We'll make sure we're working on the radial gradient, the circular one. And starting from the middle, we'll just drag out like that. So we get a kind of lighter center and a darker edge. We'll put a little bit of white in there as well. Let's get white as our foreground color. We'll get a very small paintbrush and add a dot of white just to give a little highlight, a little zing point. Then to really blend it in, we'll go to filter, blur, and Gaussian blur. Okay, so we're going to Gaussian blur. That's too much, just a little bit like that, just to soften down the edges and soften in that blending. Right, okay, we'll get rid of the selection, select and deselect, and we'll add another drop shadow, so another layer style, but this time it's only the drop shadow. We won't change anything, we'll leave it as it is. Right, so there's one of my pins. But we need a few more drawing pins than that. So let's just zoom out a little bit here. Out we go. Lovely. And we're going to use a nice little trick with the Move tool. So we're going to get the Move tool and we're going to hold the Alt key or the Option key on a Mac. Notice that the head of my cursor changes to a double arrow. And now I can click that little push pin and drag another copy. Keep holding the Alt and you can drag extra copies around. Here we go. And the Alt key. Like that. So every time you're holding Alt, you'll make a copy of the layer. And as the only thing on the layer was the original push pin, that's what we get. So we can keep adding them in like this. Lovely. There we go. And we need a few more down here, of course. That's lovely. And that one. And finally, oh no, there's another picture. I nearly forgot our gondolier. There we go. And over to that side as well. Put it on there. Oh, that's it. Oops. Got too many now. Typical. There we go. Look at that. Wonderful. Okay, so there we go. So there is our sort of postcard montage all pinned to our lovely new board. And we managed to fit it in just under 10 minutes.